Hi. In this video, we have discussed a number of practice questions which will be helpful for Prelims 2020. Let's proceed to the first question. Now, the first question, increase in internal production was made a priority for the first time in independent India during the Prime Ministership of. Increase in internal production was made a priority by the first Finance Minister of independent India, Mr. Shanmugam Shetty. He was finance minister during the period 1947 to 1949. It was Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru who was the prime minister during that time period, and he was the first prime minister of independent India. So the answer for this question is option D, Jawaharlal Nehru. Now the next question, which of the following countries share border with Persian Gulf? They have given Saudi Arabia, Lebanon, Oman, Iraq. So the options appear as a bit tricky. Now if you don't remember the map, you would easily think that Lebanon is also a country that is open to Persian Gulf. Now it is wrong, because Lebanon shares border with Mediterranean Sea and not with Persian Gulf. So if 2 is wrong, you can easily eliminate options B and option D. So now we are left with options A and C. From both these options, we can see that Saudi Arabia and Oman share borders with Persian Gulf. Now, with respect to Oman, the area of Musandam Peninsula actually borders the Persian Gulf. And Iraq also shares border with Persian Gulf. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C, 1, 3 and 4 only. Now, third question. Global Trends Report, an annual report on the world level trends on displacement, is released by which of the following? This Global Trends Report is released by United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. So the answer for this question is option C. Now the next question is with respect to Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister. They have given 2 statements and are asking which of the statements are correct. The first statement, Economic Advisory Council to Prime Minister has been constituted to advise the Prime Minister on all critical economic and related matter which have been referred to it by the Prime Minister. Now, the first statement is correct, because that is the main function of Economic Advisory Council. So statement 1 is correct. Now the second statement, the chairman of the Economic Advisory Council is the chief economic advisor to the Government of India. Now this statement is wrong, because the chairman of Economic Advisory Council is different from chief economic advisor of Government of India. The chief economic advisor heads the economic division of Department of Economic Affairs, which comes under Ministry of Finance. Therefore, second statement is wrong. But the Economic Advisory Council is constituted with approval from Prime Minister, that includes a separate chairman. So the correct answer for this question is option A, 1 only. This question is with reference to United Nations Human Rights Council. In the first statement, they have given 2 statements and are asking which among the above statements are not correct. So the first statement, it is responsible for strengthening the promotion and protection of human rights around the globe. We know that this statement is correct, and that is one of the main purpose of existence of this Human Rights Council of United Nations. Since this statement is correct, and they are asking which of the statements are not correct, the statement 1 should not be in the answer. And the second statement, India was elected as a member country from January 2019 for a term of 3 years. This statement is correct, because the council is made up of 47 member states, including India. That is from January 2019 for a term of 3 years. The council's membership is actually based on equitable geographical distribution with respect to 5 areas. They are African states, Asia-Pacific states, Latin American and Caribbean states, Western European and other states, and Eastern European states. If you take African states and Asia-Pacific states, totally 26 seats. 13 seats for African, 13 for Asia-Pacific. 8 seats goes for Latin American and Caribbean states, 7 for Western European and other states, 6 for Eastern European states. And India was elected as a member country from Jan 2019 for a term of 3 years in this Human Rights Council. So the second statement is also correct. And India was elected last year in the month of October 2018. So both the statements are correct. So the correct answer for this question is not both 1 and 2, but neither 1 nor 2. Option D is the correct answer. Now this question, they have given 3 statements and are asking which of the statements are correct. Now the first statement is, all member nations of BBIN are also member nations of SAARC. Now BBIN stands for Bangladesh, Bhutan, India and Nepal. We know that these four countries are member nations of SAARC also, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. So the first statement is correct. Now, second statement, India is not a member of SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, but it is a member of BBIN, that is Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal. Now, India is a member of Shanghai Cooperation Organization. In fact, both India and Pakistan became members of this Shanghai Cooperation Organization in the year 2017. So the second statement, first part is wrong, therefore the entire statement is wrong. Now the third statement states that all member countries of SAARC are also member nations of BIMSTEC. Now if you take BIMSTEC, you cannot find Afghanistan, Pakistan and Maldives. But if you take SAARC, you can see Maldives, Afghanistan and Pakistan along with India, Sri Lanka and our neighbor countries. We cannot say that all member nations of SAARC are also member nations of BIMSTEC. Therefore, the third statement is also wrong. So, we have to eliminate 2 and 3. Therefore, we will finally available with option A, 1 only. So, the answer for this question is option A, 1 only is correct. Now, this question, they have given two statements. They are asking which of the above statements is or are correct. The first statement, neonatal mortality rate means number of deaths of children for the first 28 days of life per 1,000 live births. According to WHO, this is the exact definition of neonatal mortality rate. Therefore, the first statement is correct. And this period is the most important time for a child's survival, as it is the most vulnerable period for a child's survival, because it requires highly efficient and proper health care for the child during that time. Now the second statement, Sustainable Development Goal Target 3.2 aims to reduce neonatal mortality rate to at least as low as 12 per 1,000 live births. We know that Sustainable Development Goal 3 deals with health and well-being. Target 3.2 asks all countries to aim to reduce this neonatal mortality to at least as low as 12 per 1,000 live births. So this statement is also correct. So the correct answer for this question is option C, both 1 and 2. Now this question is with respect to water verified paper audit trail. They have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. First statement, it is a printer attached with electronic voting machine. Now this statement is correct because VVPAT is an independent system that is attached with electronic voting machines that allow voters to verify their votes. That is, they can check whether the votes are cast as they have intended. It's a printer that is attached with EVM and is kept into the voting compartment. So the first statement is correct. Now the second statement, whenever there is any discrepancy in the match between VVPAT slips and EVM counts, the EVM count prevails. Now the statement is incorrect, because according to Rule 56 capital D 4B of Conduct of Elections Rules of 1961, the VVPAT slip count only prevail whenever there is any discrepancy in the match between VVPAT slips and the EVM counts. So therefore, only first statement is correct and they're asking the correct statement. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A, 1 only. Now this question is with reference to Baba Guru Nanak Devji. They have given three statements and are asking which of the statements are correct. They have asked to select the correct answer from the quotes given below. So the first statement, he is the founder of Sikhism. Now this statement is correct and he is the first among the 10 Sikh gurus. So the second statement is also correct. Kartarpur corridor is constructed by India and Pakistan as part of his 550th birth anniversary celebrations. Now this statement is also correct. So all the three statements are correct. So as we know already, from Indian side, this Kartarpur corridor will start from Dera Baba Nanak town in Gurdaspur district in Punjab till the international border between India and Pakistan. So this is from Indian side. And from Pakistan, this corridor will extend from the international border till it connects the Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Kartarpur in Pakistan. So the correct answer for this question is option D, 1, 2 and 3. Now this question is with respect to Interstate River Water Dispute Act of 1956. They have given three statements and are asking which of the above statements are incorrect. So the first statement, the central government shall constitute a water disputes tribunal for adjudication of water disputes that arises between the states. So this statement is correct. This is based on section 4 of the Act of 1956. See, when any request is received from a state government with respect to any water dispute, and also when central government is of the opinion that a dispute cannot be settled by negotiations, the central government shall constitute a river water disputes tribunal. So the central government will notify in the official gazette that a water disputes tribunal has been constituted to adjudicate the particular water dispute. So this statement is a correct statement. Now we know the question is asking for incorrect statement. So when statement 1 is correct, it cannot be in the answer. So easily you can eliminate option A, option B and option C. So the correct answer for this question is option D, 2 and 3 only. Now let's come to second statement. It tells that the chairman of the tribunal is nominated by the President of India. But according to the Act, based on section 4 subsection 2, the tribunal shall consist of a chairman and two other members who are nominated by the Chief Justice of India. So it is not the president who nominates the chairman of the tribunal, it is the Chief Justice of India. Therefore, the second statement is wrong. Now, the third statement, the decision of the tribunal is non-binding on the parties to the dispute. Now, this is also wrong because according to section 6 of the Interstate River Water Dispute Act, the central government will publish the decision of the tribunal in the official gazette, and this decision shall be final and binding on the states who are parties to the dispute. So here we find that the statements 2 and 3 are incorrect. So the correct answer will be option D, 2 and 3 only. This question is with reference to the right to vote. They have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. The first statement, it tells that the right to vote has been explicitly mentioned in the Indian Constitution. Now this statement is incorrect because nowhere in Indian Constitution the right to vote has been explicitly mentioned. So even in fundamental rights, we cannot find right to vote was directly mentioned in the Indian Constitution. So the statement is wrong. The second statement, the right to vote as of now cannot be exercised by the persons confined in prisons with the exception of those who are subjected to preventive detention under any law for the time being in force. Now this statement is correct. This is correct according to section 62, subsection 5 of the Representation of the People Act of 1951. It says that no person shall vote at any election if he is confined in a prison, but this provision does not apply to a person subjected to preventive detention. So therefore, only the second statement is correct. Therefore, the correct answer is option B, 2 only. Now, this question is with reference to Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. They have given three statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. They are asking to select the correct answer from the given quote. This IPCC is a United Nations body and the main purpose is it assesses the science related to climate change. So the first point is correct. Now the second statement, its objective is to provide governments with scientific information at all levels to develop policies at national and subnational level related to climate. So this statement is also correct. But the third statement, it conducts its own research. Now this is wrong. IPCC does not conduct its own research. The scientists who are working in IPCC, they assess various scientific and research papers that are published each year. So it is this part of assessment go into the various scientific papers and provide some kind of comprehensive summary with respect to climate change, the impact and also the future risks. So the third statement is wrong. So the correct answer for this question is option B, 1 and 2 only. Now this question is with reference to BrahMos missile. Again, they have given three statements and are asking which among the above statements are correct. The first statement, it is a hypersonic cruise missile. See, this statement is incorrect because it is a supersonic cruise missile. So when we say cruise missile, it's an unmanned self-propelled guided vehicle. See, depending upon the speed of the missiles, missiles are classified into three types. One is subsonic cruise missile, then is supersonic, then hypersonic cruise missiles. If you take subsonic cruise missile, it flies at a speed that is less than the speed of sound. Now, speed of sound is 343 meter per second, and this 343 meter per second is called as 1 Mach. Okay, so the speed of subsonic cruise missile will be less than 1 Mach or less than 343 meter per second. Now, supersonic cruise missiles are those missiles that travel at a speed of around 2 to 3 Mach. That is approximately 1 kilometer in 1 second. If you take hypersonic cruise missiles, they travel at a speed of 5 Mach. So the BrahMos missile is a supersonic cruise missile. So the first statement is incorrect. Now the second statement, it operates on fire and forget principle. Now this is correct because missile guidance is not required after the launch of the missile. because it can hit the target even though the launcher is not in the line of sight of the target. Now, the last statement, it says that it is uniquely configured for installing in ships, submarines, aircrafts and on ground vehicles. Now this statement is correct, and that is one of the special feature of BrahMos missile. Overall, the missile can be configured for installing in ships, submarines, aircrafts and ground vehicles. So the correct answer for this question is option C, 2 and 3 only. Now this question is with reference to boiled buffalo. They are asking which among the following statements are correct. Now the first statement, it is found only in the northeastern region of India. Wild buffaloes are found in northeastern region and also in central India, particularly in the state of Chhattisgarh. And according to Wildlife Trust of India, the estimated population of wild buffalo in the northeastern region is around some 3,000 to 4,000 individuals. And they say that within the Indian landscape, the northeastern region constitutes the largest population of wild buffaloes. At national level, if you take the total number of wild buffaloes in India, they constitute 92% of world population of wild buffalo. So we can say more than 90% of wild buffaloes are found in India. So the first statement is incorrect. But if appropriate conservation measures are not taken to protect the available wild buffaloes in the central Indian region, maybe in future, this statement may become correct if the wild buffaloes become extinct in the region of central India. Now let's come to the second statement. They are saying it is protected by the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Now this statement is correct, and wild buffaloes are protected under Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. So the second statement is correct. Now the third statement, it is listed as endangered by the International Union for Conservation of Nature's Red List. Now this statement is also correct. According to IUCN, total matured individuals are roughly around some 2,500 only. However, overall we can say some 3,000 to 4,000 individuals are there in the world. And their population trend is decreasing. So they have been listed as endangered by IUCN Red List. So the correct statements are 2 and 3. So the correct answer should be option C, 2 and 3 only. Now let's go to the next question. Consider the following statements with reference to diphtheria. They have given three statements and are asking which of the above statements are not correct. First statement says it is a contagious disease. When we say contagious, it is communicable disease. That is, the disease can easily transmit from one person to another. So diphtheria is an infection of nose and throat that can spread easily through direct contact with the infected person through infected cough or sneeze droplets. So the statement one is correct. Now the second statement, it is caused by a virus. Now we know that it is caused by a microorganism for sure. But it is not a virus, it is bacteria. So it is caused by a bacterium called as Corynebacterium diphtheria. So therefore the second statement is not correct. Now the third statement, until now there is no vaccine for the disease. Now this statement is wrong, because diphtheria or pertussis is a vaccine preventable disease. So the third statement is wrong. So they are asking which of the above statements are not correct. Only first statement is correct. So the answer should be option D, 2 and 3 only. This question is with reference to Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So they have given three statements and are asking to select the correct statements based on the given codes. The first statement, CSIR works under Ministry of Science and Technology. CSIR was established in 1942 and at present it is working under Ministry of Science and Technology. And the vice president of this organization is the Minister for Science and Technology. So the first statement is correct. The second statement says it is a body registered under Societies Registration Act of 1860. Now this statement is also correct. Now the third statement, it is presided by the Prime Minister of India. Now this statement is also correct. The president of this organization is the Honorable Prime Minister of India. So the correct answer for this question is option D, 1, 2 and 3. Now this question is with respect to National Essential Diagnostics List. They have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. Now first statement, it consists of general laboratory tests that are required for routine patient care and for diagnosis of a wide array of both communicable and non-communicable diseases. See, this statement is correct. So it consists of essential lists of diagnostic tests that have to be carried out by the health providers. The second statement, it has been developed and launched in India by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Now this statement is incorrect because it was developed and recently released in India by the Indian Council of Medical Research. Earlier in December 2018, the Indian Council of Medical Research has released the draft of National Essential Diagnostic List for comments and feedbacks, but recently they have finalized it and have uploaded in their website. So the correct answer for this question is option A, because only the first statement is correct. Now this question is with respect to persons belonging to Santal tribe. They have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. First statement, they are the people belonging to the scheduled tribes who live only in the state of Odisha. Now this statement is wrong because persons belonging to Santal tribe are also living in the states of Bihar, Jharkhand, Tripura and West Bengal. And in all these states, they have also been notified as scheduled tribes in the list of scheduled tribes. Other than Jharkhand, they are called as Santals, and in Jharkhand, they are called as Santals. Now the second statement, they are listed as particularly vulnerable tribal group. Now this statement is not correct because they are not classified under PVTG category in any of these states. So the correct answer for this question is option D, because both the statements are wrong. Now this question is with respect to New Space India Limited. They have given three statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. The first statement, the New Space India Limited is the commercial arm of DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization. Now this statement is incorrect. This is because the New Space India Limited is a commercial arm of ISRO under the Department of Space. So it was set up as a fully owned central public sector enterprise on 6th March of 2019. Now the purpose is to commercially exploit the R&D work of ISRO. And it also carries out some commercial work for other constituent units of Department of Space. It will perform the role of small satellite technology transfer to industries, and it will also manufacture small satellite launch vehicle in collaboration with private sector, and it will also produce PSLV launch vehicles through Indian industry. It will also produce and market space-based products and services. It will also market spin-off technologies and products and services both in India and abroad. So these are the objectives of New Space India Limited. Now let's come to the second statement. The objective is to spearhead commercialization of space products, including production of launch vehicles, transfer of technologies, and marketing of space products. So these are the functions carried out by NSIL, and the second statement is correct. Now the third statement, Antrix Corporation Limited is the first commercial arm of ISRO. Now this statement is correct. It is also a fully owned Government of India company under the administrative control of Department of Space. It was established in September 1992. So the third statement is also correct. So therefore we find statement 2 and statement 3 are correct, and therefore the correct answer for this question is option C, 2 and 3 only. This question is with respect to National Air Quality Index. They have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. Now the first statement, there are six air quality index categories which are decided based on the ambient concentrations of air pollutants and their likely health impacts. See, this statement is correct, and the six categories are good, satisfactory, moderately polluted, poor, very poor and severe. Now the second statement, both particulate matter 2.5 and particulate matter 10 are part of the air pollutants that are measured as a part of this index. Now this statement is also correct. See, around 8 air pollutants are checked. They are PM10, PM2.5, NO2, SO2, carbon monoxide, ozone, ammonia and lead. Therefore, both the statements are correct. Therefore, the correct answer is option C, both 1 and 2. Now this question is with respect to Central Pollution Control Board. They have given again two statements asking which are the statements are correct. First, it is a non-statutory body. Central Pollution Control Board is a statutory body that was constituted under Water Act of 1974. So the statement is wrong. Now the second statement, one of its principal functions is to improve the quality of air, to prevent, control and abate air pollution in India. This statement is correct. Now, this is based on Air Act of 1981. So, only the second statement is correct. Therefore, the correct answer is option B, 2 only. Now, this question is with respect to total fertility rate. There are two statements asking which of the statements are correct. First statement, total fertility rate means the total number of children born or likely to be born to women of childbearing age in her lifetime. Now, this definition is correct. So, the first statement becomes correct. Now, the second statement, as per NFHS-4 data, the TFR of India is higher in urban areas when compared to the rural areas in India. Now, this statement is wrong because it is other way around. It is higher in rural areas when compared to urban areas in India. So, only the first statement is correct. So, the correct answer for this question is option A, 1 only. This question, they have given two statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. Now, the first statement, both Tibetan grey wolf and Indian grey wolf are found in peninsular India. Now, this statement can be easily eliminated logically. See, the statement is saying it is Tibetan grey wolf. Obviously, it cannot be found in peninsular India. While Indian grey wolf can be found in some 8 states such as Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. The Tibetan grey wolf can be found in Himalayan landscape, particularly in the elevation between 3000 meter to 4000 meter. And that is one of the reason why the Tibetan grey wolf is called as Himalayan grey wolf. So the first statement is incorrect. The second statement, the Indian grey wolf is protected under Schedule 2 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. So this statement is incorrect. This is because it is protected under Schedule 1 of WPA 1972. Now, two other animals, one is Tibetan grey wolf and another is leopard cat. These two animals are also listed in Schedule 1 of WPA. Now, the difference between Schedule 1 and Schedule 2, 3 and 4 is that with respect to Section 11 of WPA 1972, for Schedule 1 animals, they can be hunted only if they become dangerous to human life or only if they become disabled or deceased beyond recovery. And this permission has to be given by Chief Wildlife Warden. But the animals specified in Schedule 2, Schedule 3, Schedule 4 can be hunted on two grounds for which Chief Wildlife Warden can give permission. One, if they become dangerous to human life. Two, if they become dangerous to property. This property also includes standing crops on any land. Now, given a case, a Schedule 1 specified animal, if it creates damages to property, it cannot be killed. Whereas those animals that are protected under Schedule 2, 3 or 4, if they cause damage to property, they can be hunted under the permissions of Chief Wildlife Warden. So both the statements are incorrect. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is neither one nor two. Now, this question is with respect to G7 grouping. First statement, the grouping includes 7 leading industrial countries. Now, this statement is correct. If the statement is given as 7 leading developing countries, then the statement would have been wrong. Now, the 7 leading industrial countries that are part of this G7 grouping are US, UK, Japan, Italy, Germany, France, and Canada. So, the statement is correct. Now, the second statement, in 1998, Russia was formally admitted to the group, making it the G8. Now, this statement is also correct. But after the Russian annexation of Crimea, the G7 nations decided in 2014 to meet hereafter without Russia. Anyhow, the second statement is also correct. Now, the third statement, India is not a member of this grouping. See, India is not a member of this grouping. Maybe India will be admitted once it becomes a leading industrial country. But at present, India is not a member country. So, all the three given statements are correct. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option D, 1, 2 and 3. Now, this question is with respect to balance of payments. They're asking which of the following comes under capital account of India's balance of payments. We know that balance of payments is divided into two accounts. One current account, two capital account. Imports and exports come under current account. Therefore, 1 and 2 will not be part of this capital account. And we know that both foreign portfolio investment, foreign direct investment are capital investments and they come under capital account. Under the foreign investments. Other than this, we can find external assistance, external commercial borrowings, short-term credits and NRI deposits. These are also part of capital account of balance of payments. So, the correct answer for this question is Option B. Now, this question is with respect to the World Energy Cities Partnership. They have given three statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. Now, the first statement, it is established in 1995 and it is a non-profit organization whose member cities are globally recognized as international energy capitals. The member cities are recognized as international energy capitals, and our neighboring country, China, has three such cities which are member cities in this partnership. But no Indian city have become a member city in this partnership. So this makes the second statement incorrect, because it says one or more Indian cities is or are members in this partnership. Now, the moment you decide the second statement is incorrect, you can arrive at the correct answer. This you can do by eliminating the options which say the statement 2 is correct. You can eliminate option A, you can eliminate option B, and you can eliminate option D, so that the probability of attempting the correct option will become 100%. So the correct answer for this question is option C, 1 and 3. Now, coming to the third statement, the secretariat of this partnership is in Houston in Texas state of United States. Now, this statement is correct. Houston is called as the energy capital of America. Third statement is correct. Only the first and third statements are correct. So the answer is option C. Now, this question is with reference to Paris Agreement. We have been given two statements and they are asking which of the above statements are correct. The Paris Agreement's central aim is to strengthen the global response to the threat of climate change by keeping a global temperature rise this century well below 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels, and to pursue efforts to limit the temperature increase even further to 1.5 degrees Celsius. Now, this statement is correct. This is the main ambition of this Paris Climate Accord or Paris Climate Agreement. Now, coming to the second statement, this landmark agreement was reached in 2015 on the 21st session of Conference of Parties to the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. Now, this statement is correct. The 21st session of COP was held in Paris, and that is why it is named as Paris Climate Accord or Paris Climate Agreement. See, the Conference of the Parties of UNFCCC is the supreme decision-making body of the convention. Here, when we say convention, it means United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. And also know that the Conference of the Parties, they meet every year. Every year, the presidency with respect to the COP also rotates among 5 recognized UN regions. Not only presidency, also the venue of this Conference of the Parties. The 5 regions are African region, Asian region, Latin America and the Caribbean, Central and Eastern Europe, Western Europe and others. This sessions of COP are also called as International Climate Change Conference. Last year, it was conducted in Katowice in Poland in the month of December. Both the options are correct. Therefore, the correct answer is option C, both 1 and 2. Now, this question is with reference to CITES convention. They have given 3 statements and are asking which of the above statements are correct. First statement, the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora is an international agreement to regulate the international trade of plants and animals, including their products and derivatives, to ensure their survival in the wild. Now, this statement is correct. Now, the second statement, India is not a party to this agreement. India has been a party to this convention since 1976, after the agreement came into force in 1975. So the second statement is incorrect here. India is a party to this agreement or this convention. Third statement, once the second statement is wrong, we can eliminate option B and option D, and this increases our probability of attempting the correct answer to 50%. Now, the third statement, Appendix 1 includes species threatened with extinction, and the trade in specimens of these species is permitted only in exceptional circumstances. The first and third statements are correct. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. Which of the following animals are classified as vulnerable under the International Union for Conservation of Nature Red List of Threatened Species? Star tortoise, smooth-coated otter, small-clawed otter, and tokay gecko. The first three animals are now protected under Appendix 1 of CITES Convention, as the 18th Conference of the Parties to CITES Convention recently approved India's proposal for better protection of these three animals, star tortoise, smooth-coated otter and small-clawed otter. All these three animals are also listed as vulnerable in IUCN Red List. Tokay gecko has been listed as least concern. So therefore, fourth point should not be there in options. So we can eliminate option C and D. So the correct answer for this question is option B, 1, 2 and 3 only. Now this question is with reference to Commonwealth Parliamentary Association. They have given two statements asking which of the above statements are not correct. Now the first statement, it is a voice of the parliamentary democracy across the world. See, Commonwealth Parliamentary Association is the voice of parliamentary democracy across the Commonwealth countries. So the first statement is incorrect, not across the world. Now the second statement, the objective of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association is to promote rule of law and individual rights and freedoms and also to pursue the ideals of parliamentary democracy. Now this statement is correct. So the incorrect statement is first statement. Therefore, option A becomes correct answer. Now this question is with reference to werewolf syndrome. Few kids in Spain getting affected by this syndrome because of medicine mix-up or because of wrong treatment of gastric reflux. This syndrome is also called as hypertrichosis, which refers to excessive hair growth. So therefore, the correct answer for this question is option D, a medical condition that causes excessive hair growth in the human body. So the correct answer is option D. These are some of the practice questions for the day. If you like the video, click the like button, comment, share and subscribe to Shankar AIS Academy YouTube channel for more updates and content on civil service exam preparation.